in every culture that I've been to on this planet, I see a gender problem. And I'll explain that. Sex is my genetic basis, my chromosomes, XX, XY, can't change that. Gender is how you're treated, how I treat a person, or how they want to be treated. They're two different things. So when we studied physical literacy between boys and girls, and in older adults, in males and females, what we found was that girls, even though they should have the same movement competence as boys, just like they should read and write the same as boys, just like they should have the same math skills as boys, were falling behind the boys at age 8 in their ability to move and all the different movement skills that they need to have. Run, jump, hop, skip, throw. Then what happened was, in physical literacy terms, when they lost their competence to move, they lost their confidence to move the year later. And a year after that, they started to be less motivated to participate in activity. And then, tragically, they associated unhappiness with movement. From age 8 to age 13, that happens, resulting in girls going from 30 or 40% physically active, which is a tragedy already, to less than 3%. Because of physical literacy, we now know why girls exit the physical activity world. And it's due to gender mistreatment, which is perpetrated by our entire culture, thinking about girls differently than boys with regard to movement. It's like going back and saying, very inappropriately, girls shouldn't do math. Well, nobody would tolerate that in any developed country. Well, we are tolerating physical illiteracy in women. That needs to be eradicated immediately. It's another problem of society, and it generates massive downstream consequences. Young girls at 16, 17, 18 who play soccer or football and basketball rupture their anterior cruciate ligament 6 times to every 1 boy. If you actually give them the movement skills, like the boys and like have, that they should have as well, the injury rate goes from 6 to 1 to 1.5 to 1. That's a massive change in cost to society, never mind personal tragedy, on one injury. So that gender mistreatment is a very serious effect, not just on simple injuries like that, but on mental well-being as well.